It's the biggest ick.
People like wrestling. You are a ho.
Wrestlers seem to get stuck and attached to certain promotions in the wrestling world, or they can't seem to get over while floating around the independent circuit. But this isn't the case for Matt Cardona. From humble beginnings to the bright lights of WWE, and now in promotions like MLW, Impact, GCW, and beyond, Cardona's journey has been one of ups and downs, and everything in between. So let's ride through the career of the man who defined the Internet Championship era, and continues to make waves in the wrestling world by being the self-proclaimed Indie God and Deathmatch King. Cardona's journey began under the guidance of Mikey Whipwreck in 2004, when he debuted in New York Wrestling Connection, NYWC. He initially went by the name Brett Matthews, and destiny already begun to smile upon him. Forming a dynamic partnership with Brian Myers, their climb to success was rapid, capturing the NYWC Tag Team Championship. Cardona's first taste of WWE came in 2005, when he faced Matt Morgan on SmackDown. This marked the beginning of his developmental journey in WWE. Renamed Brett Major, while Myers became Brian Major, the duo found gold in Deep South Wrestling, DSW, when they secured the DSW Tag Team Championship, only to face the inevitable highs and lows that come with wrestling gold. Their journey eventually led them to Ohio Valley Wrestling, OVW, where they added more accolades to their resume. But in 2007, a significant turning point in his career was on the horizon. This turning point saw him embracing a new identity, Zack Ryder. The first step onto the grand stage came in May 2007, when they were promoted to the main roster. Initially, their journey unfolded on WWE's ECW brand, a stepping stone to bigger things. It's worth noting that their early days were marked by mixed success, as they managed to clinch victory in their debut match, yet struggled to string together a series of wins. Their biggest breakthrough came on November 9th, when they triumphed in a fierce battle royal, earning the right to challenge for the WWE Tag Team Championship. However, despite their tenacity and talent, victory eluded them on this occasion. The turning point for the Major Brothers came at Armageddon, a pay-per-view event where they made a dramatic statement. Donning costumes reminiscent of Edge, they inserted themselves into the World Heavyweight Championship match. Their interference, cleverly replacing Edge at key moments, helped the Rated R superstar secure the title. Following this dramatic shift, the Major Brothers were unveiled as associates of SmackDown General Manager Vicky Guerrero and her partner Edge. The brothers transformed, not just in character but also in name, with Cardona adopting the moniker Zack Ryder. Often referred to as the Rated R Entourage by commentators Michael Cole and John Bradshaw Layfield, they became integral members of the faction known as La Familia. La Familia's reign on SmackDown's storyline landscape was particularly dominant through 2008. Alongside Chavo Guerrero and the imposing enforcer Bam Neely, Ryder and Hawkins wreaked havoc, proving their loyalty to Edge and Guerrero's vision. Their interference in the showdown between Edge and The Undertaker at WrestleMania 24 added another chapter to their story. However, despite their efforts, The Undertaker prevailed in a bout that's remembered as an epic clash in wrestling history. The pinnacle of their alliance came at the Great American Bash on July 20th, 2008, when Curt Hawkins and Zack Ryder seized the WWE Tag Team Championship in a thrilling fatal four-way match. The pivotal moment came when Hawkins pinned Jesse, clinching the championships. This victory also marked them as the youngest tag team to hold these titles. They'd then go on to lose the titles to Carlito and Primo in their first televised title defense match. The twists and turns in their journey continued, as on April 15th, 2009, Zack Ryder was drafted back to ECW as part of the 2009 supplemental draft, effectively bringing an end to their tag team partnership. This draft signified the start of a new chapter in both of their careers, with fresh opportunities and challenges awaiting each of them individually. As Zack Ryder, he made a return to ECW on the 5th of May 2009 and continued to evolve his character, It was in ECW that Cardona truly began to shine as he developed the Long Island loudmouth persona. It was a shift from a more reserved persona to a flashy, self-assured, and at times arrogant, Long Island Guido character. This change was evident in his new appearance. Short hair, a bronze complexion, stylish sunglasses, a headband, and unique ring attire. Ryder didn't just look different. He came off more confident with catchphrases like woo woo woo, and you know it, becoming a central part of his persona. Despite these flashy changes, Ryder faced early challenges in his singles career. His first singles match was on May 7th, 2009, which ended in defeat against Finlay. However, Ryder persevered, and on May 19th he secured his first singles victory on an episode of ECW on Sci-Fi against a jobber. And this match has since become memorable for an incident involving this jobber having a wardrobe malfunction, and it's infamously dubbed the Exploding Trunks match. Zack Ryder's journey reached new heights when on September 15th, he emerged triumphant in a 10-man battle royal, earning a shot at the ECW Championship. Although he displayed remarkable resilience, Ryder came up short against the reigning champion Christian. In November, a new dimension was added to Ryder's character when he became embroiled in a love angle with the striking Rosa Mendez, who became his valet. Meanwhile, he was also locked in a feud with Tommy Dreamer, which culminated in a pivotal match on December 29th. In this showdown, Zack Ryder emerged victorious, sealing Dreamer's departure from the company. When the ECW brand drew to a close in February 2010, Zack Ryder and Rosa Mendez transitioned to the Raw brand. Ryder's arrival on Raw was marked by a victory over Primo on the February 25th episode of Superstars. However, during the Viewer's Choice episode of Raw, Ryder faced new challenges and opportunities. Teaming with The Miz, they secured a victory against John Morrison and R-Truth. And the following week, Ryder found himself in a title match for the United States Championship in a fatal four-way contest, but he couldn't secure the gold. In August, Ryder faced a unique opportunity when he was granted the WWE Championship match against Sheamus. The match lasted 11 seconds, marking the second shortest WWE Championship match in WWE history. During this period, Zack Ryder's influence extended beyond the squared circle. He took on the role of a mentor on the second season of NXT, guiding Titus O'Neil. Together, they made their debut but faced defeat against John Morrison and Eli Cottonwood. Unfortunately, Titus O'Neil was the first rookie eliminated from the second season, and Ryder himself tasted defeat on the July 27th episode of NXT against Percy Watson. For the remainder of 2010 and well into 2011, Ryder primarily featured on the non-branded Superstars show, occasionally teaming with Primo. His popularity during this period was underscored when he won a 2010 Slammy Award for Most Annoying Catchphrase in December, a testament to his growing presence in the WWE landscape. Zack Ryder's journey was far from over, and this chapter set the stage for the rise of the internet champion in years to come. Frustrated with his underutilization in WWE, Zack Ryder decided to take matters into his own hands and embarked on a groundbreaking journey that would reshape his career. In February 2011, he introduced a YouTube web series called Z, True Long Island Story, as a platform to promote his character and connect with fans. This innovative move would change the course of his career. Ryder's web series rapidly gained popularity, resonating with fans and creating a dedicated following. His Z True Long Island Story became a sensation in the WWE universe. What made this endeavor truly remarkable was that Ryder was not always featured on television, but his online presence sparked a revolution. His custom t-shirts even sold out, reflecting his newfound fanbase and their support. By June, arenas echoed with "We Want Ryder" chants. Despite Zack Ryder's limited appearances on WWE television, audiences at Raw and the Capital Punishment pay-per-view called for his inclusion, signalling a groundswell of support that couldn't be ignored. As a result of his grassroots movement, WWE began to acknowledge Zack Ryder's popularity and gradually integrated him into their programming. Between April and June, Ryder started to appear on Raw more frequently, often engaging in backstage segments, including interactions with John Cena. On June 6, 2011, Zack Ryder had his first match on Raw for that year, facing off against Kofi Kingston. Ryder's journey continued on the June 16th episode of Superstars, when he faced his former tag partner, Primo, in his hometown of Long Island and emerged victorious. The tides of fortune turned further in Ryder's favour, when on the July 29th episode of SmackDown, he was appointed as the assistant to SmackDown general manager Theodore Long. This strategic move allowed him to make appearances on both Raw and SmackDown, expanding his reach and visibility. On the September 19th episode of Raw, Zack Ryder achieved a significant milestone by defeating United States champion Dolph Ziggler in a non-title match, with a little help from guest star Hugh Jackman. This victory earned him an opportunity for the United States Championship the following week, and at Vengeance, but both attempts were thwarted by an interference from Jack Swagger. Ryder's meteoric rise in WWE was punctuated when he teamed up with John Cena in a main event on the November 7th episode of Raw, facing The Miz and R-Truth. Although they faced defeat, it was a testament to his elevated status. At Survivor Series in November, with Ryder not actively competing, the We Want Ryder chants echoed throughout the event. These chants were heard during key moments, including during the United States Championship match and The Rock's show closing speech.
I'm a fan too. We want Ryder, woo woo woo, all that shit. I love all that. Yeah.
Underlining his popularity. December 5th, 2011 marked a turning point in Zack Ryder's journey. He faced a pivotal match against John Cena, and the winner earning a WWE Championship match opportunity. In a stunning display of camaraderie, Cena surrendered his WWE Championship match, providing Ryder with a second chance, this time for the United States Championship. This second opportunity came in the form of a no-disqualification match against then-World Heavyweight Champion Mark Henry. This triumph propelled Zack Ryder to greater heights as he earned a United States Championship match at TLC. At the event, Ryder secured a historic victory over Dolph Ziggler, capturing his first ever singles title. With his newfound championship accolade, Zack Ryder left his position as assistant to SmackDown general manager to fully embrace his championship commitments. As Zack Ryder's whirlwind journey through 2011 culminated with triumphs and growing fan support, 2012, unfortunately, marked a stark contrast in his WWE career. The transition from an internet sensation to a consistently featured WWE star proved to be a challenge, leading to a decline in his status. The Baltimore Sun noted that while 2011 had been a dream year, 2012 proved to be a nightmare for Zack Ryder. His YouTube success seemed to dissipate, and his appearances on WWE television became scarce after WrestleMania. By March 2012, John Cena publicly acknowledged Ryder's fall from grace, noting that he had seemingly fallen off the face of the earth, despite his 2011 success. In early 2012, Ryder became entangled in a romantic storyline, attempting to woo Eve Torres. As a friend of Cena, Ryder also found himself targeted by the menacing Kane, who was embroiled in a feud with Cena at the time. Ryder's misfortunes began to accumulate when he lost his United States Championship to Jack Swagger on the January 16th episode of Raw. Ryder never received an automatic title rematch despite being the former champion. His troubles escalated as he faced brutal attacks at the hands of Kane. The Big Red Monster chokeslammed Ryder through the Raw stage and gave him a tombstone piledriver during the Royal Rumble. One of the defining moments of this challenging period came on February 13th episode of Raw. Confined to a wheelchair, Ryder watched in heartbreak as Eve Torres kissed John Cena after Cena rescued her from a kidnapping attempt by Kane. In a cruel twist, Kane later wheeled Ryder off the stage, causing further harm. Eve's shocking heel turn added more misery to Ryder's life, as she confessed to never genuinely caring for him and had disingenuously used him for fame and publicity. Ryder's return to Raw on the 5th of March led to a confrontation with Eve over her actions. However, she managed to seduce him and share the backstage kiss, leaving Ryder in turmoil. Despite wrestling sporadically and experiencing these tribulations, Ryder failed to gain retribution against Kane for the physical and emotional torment he had suffered throughout 2012. At the Over the Limit pre-show, Kane emerged victorious over Ryder in a clear display of dominance. The latter part of 2012 did offer a glimmer of hope for Ryder when he triumphed in the Great American Bash 20-Man Battle Royal on the July 3rd episode of SmackDown, earning him the role of acting SmackDown General Manager. At the Night of Champions pre-show on September 16th, Ryder won a 16-man Battle Royal to become the number one contender for the United States Championship. However, his quest for the championship gold was thwarted when he failed to capture the title from defending champion Antonio Cesaro. With the close of 2012, Ryder candidly expressed his disappointment, labeling the year as a disappointment. In November 2014, Ryder announced that he had torn his rotator cuff. Then he returned on January 25th, 2015 at the Royal Rumble, and he entered the Royal Rumble match at number 9 and was quickly eliminated by Bray Wyatt. Ryder also participated in the second annual Andre the Giant Memorial Battle Royale at WrestleMania 31, which was won by Big Show. Ryder, being accompanied by the cast of Entourage, answered Cena's United States Open Challenge on the May 25th episode of Raw in his hometown, but he failed to win after a counted 450 splash. On the June 4th episode of SmackDown, Ryder accepted the open challenge by Kevin Owens for the NXT Championship, which he also lost. Zack Ryder embarked on a new chapter of his WWE journey as he transitioned to the developmental territory of NXT. There, he forged a tag team partnership with the enthusiastic Mojo Rawley, marking the formation of the Hype Bros. Their debut in NXT was met with excitement as they confronted adversaries like the Mechanics and Jason Jordan and Chad Gable, amassing several notable victories. A highlight for the duo occurred at NXT TakeOver Brooklyn, when the Hype Bros joined forces with Enzo Amore and Colin Cassidy to triumph in an electrifying 8-man tag team match. Although their bid for the NXT Tag Team Championship ended in defeat during a match on the October 16th episode of NXT, Zack Ryder in particular made an impact by showcasing his resilience in a 26-man battle royal on the October 22nd episode of NXT to determine the number one contender for the NXT Championship. While Ryder's presence grew in NXT, he simultaneously continued to appear on WWE's main roster. In a series of singles matches, Ryder faced formidable opponents including Bo Dallas, Rusev, and The Miz. He achieved a mixed bag of results, trading wins and losses with the likes of Adam Rose, Heath Slater, Cody Rhodes as Stardust, and Tyler Breeze. And the pinnacle of Ryder's journey as a singles competitor came at WrestleMania 32. In an unexpected turn of events, he substituted for Neville in the ladder match for the Intercontinental Championship, and he emerged victorious. However, his championship glory was short-lived. The following night on Raw, Ryder faced The Miz in a title rematch, where interference by Maurice thwarted his chances of retaining the championship. The formation of the Hype Bros tag team with his former partner Mojo Rawley was a significant development. The duo reunited at the SummerSlam pre-show, competing alongside the Usos, Jimmy and Jay, and the American Alpha, Jason Jordan and Chad Gable, in a victorious 12-man tag team match. The Hype Bros journey culminated in an 18 tournament to crown the WWE SmackDown Tag Team Champions. The duo's road was marked by victories over the Vaudevillains in the first round, but their journey ended in the semi-finals when they faced Heath Slater and Rhino. In December 2016, Zack Ryder suffered a knee injury during an episode of SmackDown, leading to a 6-month hiatus from in-ring competition. He eventually made a triumphant return to SmackDown on the June 13th, 2017 episode, reuniting with Mojo Rawley. Their partnership, however, took a surprising turn as Mojo Rawley attacked Zack Ryder after a loss. This marked the dissolution of the Hype Bros, and the two would face each other at Clash of Champions and in a tournament for the United States title, with Mojo Rawley emerging victorious in both encounters. At WrestleMania 34, Zack Ryder participated in the Andre the Giant Memorial Battle Royal, but was eliminated by his former partner, Mojo Rawley. In April 2018, Zack Ryder embarked on a new chapter in his WWE career, as he was drafted to the Raw brand. However, his return to Raw didn't come without its challenges. Before his reintegration into the Raw roster, Ryder suffered a series of severe injuries including MCL, ACL, and calf muscle strains during a match. These injuries proved to be a significant setback for Ryder, causing him to miss out on the scheduled competition at the Greatest Royal Rumble event. Ryder made his triumphant return to in-ring action on the May 7th episode of Main Event, where he faced his longtime friend and former tag partner, Curt Hawkins, and he emerged victorious in their friendly showdown. The next few months saw Ryder and Curt Hawkins reignite their partnership. The former tag team champions reunited, bringing a sense of nostalgia and camaraderie to the fans. Their collective efforts were directed at the WWE Raw Tag Team Champions, The Revival, as they embarked on a memorable feud with the championship-holding duo. The culmination of this partnership reached its peak on the grand stage of WrestleMania 35, when Ryder and Hawkins, fueled by their determination and tag team chemistry, faced The Revival and emerged victorious, capturing the WWE Raw Tag Team Championships. Their victory marked a heartwarming moment for the WWE Universe, as these two lifelong friends celebrated their championship win. The following night on Raw, Ryder and Hawkins made their first successful title defense against The Revival in a rematch, proving that their championship was no fluke. They would later extend their success by defeating The Revival yet again on the April 29th episode of Raw. However, despite their championship status, Ryder and Hawkins were noticeably absent from WWE television and predominantly featured at live events. Their on-screen appearances were scarce, with a limited presence on WWE programming. For instance, during May, they had only two notable televised appearances, a loss to the Viking Raiders on the May 6th episode of Raw, and a victory against Luke Gallows and Carl Anderson on the May 27th episode of Main Event. The journey took another unexpected turn on the June 10th episode of Raw, when Ryder and Hawkins lost the Raw Tag Team Championships in a Tag Team Triple Threat match, also involving the Usos. This marked the end of their championship reign, but their bond remained unbroken. Ryder and Hawkins continued to participate in WWE events, including the Survivor Series on November 24th, where they competed in a 10-man Interbrand Battle Royal. However, their run in the match was cut short as they were the third team eliminated. In what would be his final pay-per-view appearance, Ryder, alongside Hawkins, faced the formidable Viking Raiders at Elimination Chamber on March 8th, 2020, but fell short in their quest for victory. The conclusion of Zack Ryder's WWE career came the following night on Raw, when he faced Bobby Lashley, resulting in defeat. This bout would be remembered as Ryder's last match under the WWE banner. On April 15, 2020, in the wake of budget cuts stemming from the C-19 pandemic, both Curt Hawkins and Zack Ryder were released from their WWE contracts, marking the end of Ryder's remarkable 15-year run with the company. Following his departure from WWE, Matt Cardona, now wrestling under his real name, marked on a new journey in the world of professional wrestling by aligning himself with All Elite Wrestling. This partnership was characterized by a limited appearance deal, marking an exciting chapter in Cardona's career. Cardona's AEW journey kicked off on the July 29th, 2020 episode of Dynamite, and in dramatic fashion. In a surprising debut, he made a memorable entrance coming to the aid of Cody Rhodes, who was under attack by the formidable duo of Alex Reynolds and John Silver, both members of the Dark Order. One of Cardona's notable AEW appearances was on the All Out pay-per-view on September 5th, 2020. He teamed up with wrestling luminaries like Dustin Rhodes, QT Marshall, and Scorpio Sky in an electrifying 8-man tag match. Their opponents were Mr. Brody Lee, Colt Cabana, Evil Uno, and Stu Grayson, all members of the Dark Order. Cardona and his team emerged victorious in this thrilling contest, providing fans with a memorable moment. However, it was reported that this match would mark Cardona's last appearance with the promotion, as his contract with AEW came to an end. Despite his limited time in AEW, Cardona made an impact with his debut, his in-ring prowess, and his contributions to memorable moments in the promotion, showcasing his versatility and adaptability as a professional wrestler. Cardona's journey in the world of professional wrestling didn't stop there. He embarked on a new journey with Impact Wrestling. Similar to his agreements with other promotions, Cardona's tenure with Impact was defined by a limited appearance deal, reflecting the ever-loving landscape of his wrestling career. Cardona's Impact Wrestling story commenced with a captivating and unexpected debut on January 16th, 2021, at the Hard to Kill pay-per-view. In a thrilling match, he faced off against Ace Austin and secured the victory, setting the stage for what would be a noteworthy run in the promotion. On the January 26th episode of Impact, Cardona joined forces with Josh Alexander, and together, they exhibited their prowess by defeating the formidable team of Ace Austin and Madman Fulton. Their collective efforts showcased Cardona's adaptability and his ability to form successful partnerships within the promotion. Shortly thereafter, Cardona found himself engaged in a heated feud with his former tag team partner Brian Myers. This intense rivalry saw Cardona and Eddie Edwards facing Myers and Hernandez at No Surrender, where they faced a challenging defeat. The feud persisted, leading to a singles match at Rebellion, which saw Cardona on the losing end once again. However, the culmination of this rivalry occurred at Slammiversary, where Cardona and his real-life fiancé, Chelsea Green, teamed up to defeat Myers and Tennille Dashwood. Their victory marked a triumphant conclusion to the conflict. At Bound for Glory, Cardona participated in the Call Your Shot Gauntlet match, demonstrating his resilience and determination by reaching the final stages of the match. The journey continued at Turning Point, where Cardona faced off against W. Morrissey, but was defeated with the assistance of Moose. On the December 2nd episode of Impact, Cardona managed to pin Moose in a tag team match, subsequently earning himself an opportunity to contend for the Impact World Championship at Hard to Kill. On January 8th, 2022, at Hard to Kill, Cardona competed in the high-stakes three-way match for the Impact World Championship. Although he demonstrated unwavering tenacity, he was ultimately unable to secure the championship. In a surprising turn of events, Cardona found himself embroiled in controversy on the February 3rd episode of Impact by defeating Jordan Grace for the Impact Digital Media Championship in a heated encounter that involved a steel chair. This triumph also marked a shift in Cardona's career as he embraced a villainous persona. At No Surrender, Cardona faced Jordan Grace once more, securing a victory by disqualification when Grace delivered a low blow. He retained his championship against Grace in a Dot Combat match on the February 24th episode of Impact, solidifying his position as a formidable champion. Furthermore, the plot thickened as Cardona reunited with Brian Myers, launching an aggressive attack on W. Morrissey during the in-ring promo. This team-up was executed with the assistance of Chelsea Green, leading to a memorable segment in Impact Wrestling. As the show progressed, Green, Myers, and Cardona collaborated to orchestrate a surprise assault on Mickie James. Cardona's reign with the Impact Digital Media Championship continued as he defended the title against the returning James Maritato, securing a successful retention in a thrilling match. However, this title reign came to an end during an independent event as Rich Swann emerged victorious in a championship bout, bringing Cardona's time as champion to a close. Matt Cardona's Impact Wrestling journey witnessed its last chapter at Bound for Glory on October 7th, where he participated in the Call Your Shot Gauntlet. In this event, he showcased his skills by eliminating a few superstars before being eliminated by Bhupinder Gujjar. On May 14th, 2023, Cardona confirmed he was officially done with Impact Wrestling. So while I was editing this, Matt Cardona actually made his return to TNA, as it is called again now, at Bound for Glory 2023. Matt Cardona's wrestling journey took an intriguing turn when he made his presence felt in Game Changer Wrestling, GCW, a promotion known for its unique and often hardcore style of wrestling. His time in GCW would be defined by his confrontations with some of the promotion's most prominent stars and his pursuit of championship gold. The catalyst for Cardona's journey in GCW occurred on June 6, 2021, at the Zombie Walk Show held at the Showboat Hotel in Atlantic City, New Jersey. During the GCW World Championship match between Nick Gage and Jimmy Lloyd, the match ended in a no contest. The chaos continued as a hooded figure entered the ring, seemingly coming to challenge the reigning champion, Nick Gage. Fans in attendance believed the figure to be Jon Moxley, adding an element of suspense to the unfolding drama. However, when the hooded figure finally unmasked, it was none other than Matt Cardona. In the lead up to this memorable confrontation, Cardona had been taunting Nick Gage through social media, setting the stage for their eventual clash in the ring. The rivalry between the two escalated when Gage attempted to attack Cardona during a live podcast event, further fueling the anticipation for their in-ring showdown. Cardona's challenge for the GCW World Championship materialized at Night 1 of GCW Homecoming. In a high-stakes death match, Cardona defied the odds and secured the monumental victory, defeating Nick Gage to capture the GCW World Championship. This championship win marked a significant milestone in Cardona's wrestling career, as it was his first ever World Championship in any promotion. Cardona's stint in GCW introduced a unique and divisive gimmick aimed at fixing the promotion. In this role, he brought sports entertainment elements to the hardcore wrestling environment. Dressing in a style reminiscent of Vince McMahon during his time as ECW champion, he humorously referred to the fans as the GCW Universe, and even unveiled a new title design featuring a spinner version of the championship belt, all in a playful attempt to revamp the promotion's image, and the fans hated it. While Cardona's championship reign was noteworthy, it ultimately came to an end at the Art of the War Games on September 4th, 2021, where he faced off against the formidable Jon Moxley. Moxley emerged victorious in their championship encounter, closing the chapter on Cardona's championship run in GCW. Cardona's journey in GCW also saw him reunited with his former tag team partner, Brian Myers, as they teamed up with Chelsea Green to form the Major Players. The trio competed at GCW's Welcome to Heartbreak event in Los Angeles, where they faced off against X-Pac and Joey Janela in the main event, offering fans a memorable and entertaining showdown in the world of independent wrestling. Cardona's debut in NWA took place on December 4th, 2021, at the Hard Times 2 event. Making a grand entrance into the promotion, he launched a brutal attack on the reigning NWA World Heavyweight Champion, Trevor Murdoch, following Murdoch's match with Mike Knox. This dramatic debut left a lasting impression on NWA fans and set the stage for Cardona's future in the promotion. The pinnacle of Cardona's NWA career occurred on February 12, 2022, at NWA Power Trip. In a highly anticipated contest, Cardona faced off against the NWA World Heavyweight Champion Trevor Murdoch, and in an extraordinary turn of events, Cardona secured the victory over Murdoch. This championship win was a significant achievement, adding another championship to Cardona's impressive list of accolades. Cardona's championship reign in NWA was not without its challenges. During night 2 of the Crockett Cup, he defended the NWA World Heavyweight Championship against formidable Nick Aldis. The match had a unique twist, with wrestling legend Jeff Jarrett serving as the special guest referee. Cardona successfully retained the title by disqualification in a hard-fought battle against Aldis, proving his mettle as a champion. However, Cardona's championship reign faced a sudden and unfortunate setback. On June 11th, at the Always Ready event. He was compelled to vacate the NWA World Heavyweight Championship due to an injury. This turn of events was a disappointment for both Cardona and the NWA fans, as it marked an abrupt end to his championship reign. Seeking to reclaim the championship, he was forced to vacate. Cardona made a valiant effort on November 12th at Hard Times 3 in a highly competitive triple threat match for the NWA World Heavyweight Championship. Cardona faced off against the reigning champion Trevor Murdoch and the formidable Tyrus. The match concluded with Tyrus emerging victorious by pinning Murdoch, capturing the title. Cardona's quest for the NWA World Heavyweight Championship continued on February 11th, 2023, at Nuff Said. In a determined effort, he faced Tyrus in a championship match. Despite his unwavering resolve, Cardona faced a challenging opponent in Tyrus and emerged from the match in a losing effort. Matt Cardona's time in NWA was characterized by championship triumph, injury-induced setbacks, and intense competition. His journey in the NWA was a testament to his resilience and his versatility as a professional wrestler, leaving an indelible mark in the promotion's history. Cardona's journey led him to DDT Pro Wrestling, a promotion known for its unique and entertaining style. Cardona's time in DDT Pro Wrestling was highlighted by a significant championship victory, marking a new chapter in his wrestling career. The path to this championship opportunity was paved on May 21st, 2023, during the final event of the 2023 King of DDT tournament. In a stunning announcement, DDT Pro Wrestling revealed that Matt Cardona, accompanied by Steph DeLander, was set to challenge Tetsuya Endo for the coveted DDT Universal Championship. This announcement set the stage for an exciting and highly anticipated championship showdown. The momentous clash took place on July 23rd at the event known as Wrestle Peter Pan 2023. In front of a captivated audience, Cardona faced off against the reigning champion. Cardona emerged victorious in this high-stakes encounter with a display of skill, determination, and heart. He managed to defeat Tetsuya Endo, clinching the DDT Universal Championship. This victory was a testament to Cardona's ability to adapt and excel in diverse wrestling promotions, solidifying his status as a champion in the world of professional and independent wrestling. In July 2023, at Never Say Never, it was announced that Cardona had signed with Major League Wrestling. On September 3rd, Cardona, accompanied by Mr. St. Laurent, defeated Mance Warner in a no-holds-barred Kiss My Foot match. And here we are today, where Matt Cardona continues to captivate audiences in professional wrestling and independent wrestling across the world. Matt Cardona's journey through the ropes, from Zack Ryder and the Internet Champion to Matt Cardona the Indie God and Deathmatch King, is a story of perseverance and reinvention. From his early days in NYWC to capturing titles in WWE, GCW, and the NWA, Cardona has experienced the highest highs and highest lows in the wrestling world. Through it all, he's maintained his unique charisma and a connection with fans that few wrestlers can match. His career is a testament to the power of determination, adaptability, and an unshakable connection to the audience that will ensure he remains a beloved figure in professional wrestling for years to come. Like and subscribe if you enjoyed the video, and click here for another. And if you want to support us further, join our Patreon using the link in the description. You'll get exclusive benefits, access to our private community, watch-alongs, and much more. Nice one.